Good afternoon. Good afternoon. Nandito po tayo sa SM Masinag. Natagalan tayo kasi kumanap tayo ng pwesto kung saan pwedeng maupo. Kasi bawal umaupo. Kailangan alfresco ang dining because of the condition. GCQ ang Pilipinas. Okay? Yan, nandito po tayo. Nandito tayo sa SM Masinag. Sa Starbucks. Ito yung ating office away from home. At ang ating pong tatalakayin ay yung pong UK naman tayo. Pumunta tayo ng UK. Rainiel, good afternoon. Pen, Pensacola, Mike. Hi, kamusta kayo? Natagalan ako kasi kumanap ako ng area kung saan pwedeng mag-broadcast ng live. Dito sa SM City Masinag, it has to be alfresco. Kailangan na sa labas, hindi pwedeng nasa loob, bawal maupo sa loob. Okay, ang ating topic. Ang ating topic ay sa UK. Okay. UK. As a destination, if you're a resident, if you want to become a permanent resident, a student or worker sa UK, eh, kailangan meron ka sariling bangka. Kahit na bangkang papel, kailangan meron ka. If the UK is, if you're considering UK as a destination for 2022 and beyond. Hey Elizabeth, kumusta ka? Mariscon, si Vanessa, Pagod, watching from Ilocos Norte, si Miss Bailon, stay safe. Ay, talaga. Kaya nga nakamaskara tayo eh. At saka natagalan tayo because of that. Leti Perez is watching. Hi, Lady. Grace is watching. Cute po ang mask nyo. Okay. Salamat, Baby Beltran, watching from Ilocos Norte. Balikan natin ang ating topic. Okay. So, balikan natin ng UK. Generally, taasan po natin. Generally, you can apply sa UK, kayusin lang natin, okay? Generally, you can apply to settle in the UK under any of the following situations. Yan. Ito po yung indefinite leave to remain sa UK. Yan po yung parang green card ng UK. If you are a Swiss citizen, a family member or partner of a British citizen, the family member or partner of someone who has settled in the UK, and if you have a visitor's visa, okay, study visa, work visa, UK ancestry visa, retired person visa, and if you've been settled in the UK before, or you have a discretionary leave, you're in or have been in the Her Majesty's Forces, parang US Armed Forces or Philippine Armed Forces, you have been in the UK for 10 years. So, pwede ka mag-apply for settlement under the 10-year program. Or you've been in the UK legally for 10 years. Ang tawag nila doon ay long residence. So, itong iyong bangkang papel, papunta sa UK. Paano yan? Paano magkakaroon ng kulay ang migration mo sa UK? Tingnan natin. Which option would be available to you next year? Hindi pa pwedeng yan, 2021 eh. Marami pang lockdown. So, 2022 na tayo. Hello, Heart. Len Len is watching. Si Early, watching. Si... If you're a visitor, you cannot apply directly to live permanently in the UK. If you're a visitor, unless you have been in the UK legally for 10 years, then you can apply to settle because of long residence. You cannot apply directly if you're a student unless you've been in the UK legally for 10 years and could apply to settle because of long residence or there are exceptional compassionate circumstances which you must explain in detail if you choose to apply. Okay. You may, however, apply directly for settlement in the UK if you are a Ayan, itong bangkang papel na kulay dilaw. If you are a partner, a parent, a child under 18, and children who have turned 18 since first applying, and as an adult dependent relative, you may apply directly for a settlement in the UK if you have the bangkang papel na dilaw. If you're a partner of a British citizen living in the UK, ayan, ang mag-partner. Your eligibility as a partner or spouse can be depending sa years. You can have the 5-year route if you have been living in the UK for 5 years with your partner, or 2 years also with your partner, or 10 years with your partner. So yun ang eligibility. Kailangan nasa UK ka na. Okay. You can apply outside the UK directly for settlement from outside the UK if you are a partner of a British citizen living in the UK. You must be able to prove one of the following: you are in a civil partnership or marriage recognized in the UK, you've been living together in a relationship for at least 2 years when you apply, or you are a fiancé or proposed civil partner and will marry or enter into civil partnership in the UK within 6 months of arriving. It's parang fiancé visa ito ng US, or yung prospective marriage sa Australia. You also need to prove you have good knowledge of English and you can financially support yourself and your dependents. Itong pinakamahirap sa UK. Magkano kailangan mong pera na ipakita na meron ka, parang affidavit of support. How much money do you need? Income requirement, 18,600 a year. Yan ang income requirement para mabigyan ka ng visa. Plus, if you have a kid, the first child, you have to pay additional £3,800 for the first child and £18,600 for each subsequent child. You can stay in the UK for 2 years and 9 months on this visa. If you're applying as a fiancé, you can stay for 6 months. Eligibility to settle in the UK after 5 years, continuously living with your partner. So, you may apply directly for a settlement if you're outside the UK if you meet these requirements. As a parent, you may apply directly if you have permission to live in the UK with your child who is a British citizen or settled in the UK, had permission to stay after living in the UK continuously for 7 years. Ibig sabihin, dapat nasa UK ka. Yan. Nasa UK ka na. And you have permission to live in the UK with your child. Sasabihin natin kung sino yung child mamaya. You have lived in the UK for 5 or 10 years, or your child lives with you and you have either sole parental responsibility or shared responsibility, and your child's other parent is a British citizen or is settled in the UK. The child you are taking care of was under 18 when you first got permission to be in the UK. The child is not living an independent life. Ibig sabihin, wala siyang trabaho at pwede maaasa sa iyo for care. And that child has not formed his or her own family. So, pwede ka mag-apply as a parent provided you meet those requirements. However, how about this? Anong bangka ito? Papel, union jack, working. You may apply for settlement or remain indefinitely in the UK if you have a work visa under any of the following. Uy, maraming cheer ito. Cheer 1. Exceptional talent, investor, entrepreneur. Maraming mga Pilipino na nasa cheer 2. Cheer 2, minister of religion, sports person, intra-company transfer visa, general worker, representative of overseas, etc. So, nasa cheer 2. Normally, ang mga Pilipino, general visa. Also, cheer 5, kaya nakikita ninyo, and halimbawa, yung mga representative ng overseas newspaper, you can also apply for settlement if you are under this category. Balikan natin. Itong skilled worker naman, ano ito? Skilled worker, sinabi ni Priti Patel. From January 2021, skilled workers must have sponsors, merong minimum skill level, merong salary, threshold, and a new graduate immigration route for students will be available by summer of 2021. Seasonal agricultural visa pilot project to be expanded but no immigration route for residency para sa mga lower skilled workers. So kailangan hindi ka lower skilled work. Meron ding global talent scheme, top scientists, researchers to be given fast track entry in lieu of tier 1. How do you get the points? You need minimum points 70 if you're a skilled worker. Of course, you need the job offer, but not just that. The job offer must be from an approved sponsor, that's 20 points. Your skill level is appropriate, hindi natatabunan ng motorsiklo, 20 points. You can speak English at the appropriate level, even with traffic, 10 points. Your salary is at least 23,000 pounds, you get 10 points. If your salary is 25,000 pounds or above, you get 20 points. Your education can give you 10 points if you got a PhD in a subject relevant to the job or a STEM subject relevant to the job, you get 20 points. So, you need 70. You got a job offer, you got a skill level, you got an English, so that's 50. Kailangan pa ng 20 points. So, dapat ang salary mo is 25,600 para makakuha ng 70 points. Or, your occupation in short supply. Yan. So, kung maliit pa ng salary mo, but your occupation is in shortage occupation according to the Migration Advisory Committee ng UK, you get 20 points. Then, pwede ka na mag-apply. Ano yung jobs in shortage sa UK and Scotland? Ayan. You can read up on it. In the meantime, kukunin ko yung copy ko. Next list. Ayan. Nadidinig po ninyo yung ingay. Kasi hindi tayo, wala tayo sa loob eh. And then, eto, tignan natin. Ayan. Kailangan tayo magtimpla ng ating kape. At lumalamig. Oops! 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 Tayo magtimpla ng kape. Magkape tayo. Paano kung iinumin to? May mask. Okay, inom muna tayo. So, after the coffee break, balik ang mask. After the coffee break, balik ang mask. At balikan natin ang ating topic. So, yun po yung mga shortage occupation sa UK. So, you get 20 points. Ulit-ulit natin. Yan, nakikita nyo. For you to be able to have to work in the UK, you need 70 points. And those are the points wherein you can get your residency later after 5 years of working. Yan. As a student, you can live permanently in the UK if you have been in the UK legally for 10 years. And could apply to settle because of your long residence. Abangin na. So, ibig sabihin, legal ka from a student, naging nurse ka, nagtrabaho ka, umabot ka ng 10 years, nag-umpisa ka ng student, then you can live permanently in the UK as a student if you have been in the UK legally for 10 years. Yan. Or tenure legal sa in any valid visa. There are exceptional circumstances, pwede rin ito. Pwedeng naka-legal stay ka, then you have circumstances available, but you have to explain it. Hindi katulad ng isa, malinaw na meron kang legal status from student to working. So naka-tenure ka, you can apply for residency sa UK. Bangkang papel lumit. Ano naman ito? Ito yung 10 years. For example, kung nasa UK ka ng 2012, 2022, legally, you can apply for residency if you've been in the UK for 10 years and have done long residence. Long residence. If you're not eligible, you may still apply to remain in the UK because of your private life. Private, ha? Private life. Ano yan? Private life means you have permission because you joined the private life 10 years, naka 10 years ka na, in any of the following categories. You are between 18 and 24. You have been in the UK for more than half your life. So if you're 24, 12 years old pa lang nasa UK ka na. If you're 18, 9 years old pa lang nasa UK ka na. So pwede ka mag-apply under the 10-year private life settlement route. Next, if you're 25 or over, you've been in the UK for 20 years. So 5 years old pa lang nasa UK ka na. Wow! Or if you're over 18, and you have spent less than 20 years in the UK, but you had no ties with any other country. Orphan ka, for example. Ulila ka. Nasa UK ka. You are over 18, but 20 years ka nasa UK. You have no other ties in any country. Then you can apply through the 10-year private life settlement route. Or you are under 18, but you have lived in the UK for at least 7 years, and it would be unreasonable to expect you to live in a different country. Ibig sabihin, mahirap ka na bumalik. Halimbawa sa Pilipinas, hinahabol ka ng weather ng gobyerno or ng NPA or ng sino man, ng political group, ng mga assassins and terrorists. You are under 18, you're in the UK, you've been there for at least 7 years, then pwede ka mabigyan ng residency through the 10-year private life settlement route. Okay. Yun po yung ating maiksing balita. Hindi na tayo masyado magtatagal. What to watch out for and when. Mamaya babalik tayo. Iba naman topic natin, US. If you have any questions, you can give us a call. 63917-526-8472. 63917-531-8472. Ito ang nakabisang Cris Aranda. Okay. Balik tayo sa ating kape. Itong inyong kabisang Cris Aranda dito sa SM City, Masinag, nagsasabing hanggang sa susunod. Ito, bibigyan ko pa kayo ng konting yan. Ito, nandito tayo sa Starbucks natin. Yung mga, yun ay sa ano naman yun, sa Colonel Sanders. Kung sila bumili ng fried chicken, dun sila mauupo. Yung iba naman, ayan. So, pwede kayong kumain al fresco. Wala nga lang aircon. Kasi bawal sa loob eh. Bawal at dine in. So, dine out, you're outside the dining area, al fresco ang tawag nila. Yan po. Itong inyong kabisang Cris Aranda, dito sa Masinag.